In this video, I'm going to show you how to create and animate a carousel in Figma. For a beautiful iOS app, we will learn how to do horizontal scrolling in just 3.5 minutes. To create this horizontal carousel, I'm gonna do this on the level of a frame for you so you can see things more clearly. Because if we were to do it here, you won't be able to see all the items in it. So, we have one image. I'm gonna duplicate this. The shortcut by now, you know it. It's Command D or Option Drag. I dragged another card. I wanna create an auto layout on these cards. So I'm gonna select both of them. So one of them is selected, Shift, and I click on the second one. Both are selected. And to create an auto layout, I can either right click to add the auto layout, or our shortcut is Shift A. So this is gonna be my carousel, and I wanna make sure I have so many photos in it. So I'm selecting the last one. I'm gonna click Command D because we created an auto layout. Now Figma knows I need more of these. Another Command D, Command D. Like you've learned in previous tutorials, we're gonna use this beautiful plugin, Unsplash, to change these images. And you may be creating something completely different from me. So go nuts with it. Part of the rules of scrolling that we discussed before, for an element to scroll, there needs to be a container that is smaller than the actual content. So to do this, I am going to right click on this element and click frame selection. And basically, I'm creating a frame that I will call carousel container that is bigger than my actual frame. And inside this carousel container, you can see my carousel. This is my carousel container. It's as big as the content. That's not what we want. We want to resize it to become smaller than the content. So to do this, I'm clicking and dragging on it, and this is where I want it to end. So now you see, this is a carousel container. It's just small. It's only within this page. And my carousel, however, is much bigger than the container. And with my carousel container selected, I will come to prototype. I will say scroll horizontally. Now when we come to our prototype, you will see we're able to do this horizontal scroll, which beautifully shows my images. Now I want to go one step further, which is to allow the user to know that you can scroll through these flowers and there's more, that this is not just static. I want to start somewhere in between. I want to move my carousel within my container. So this is a container. It's a small piece. Remember, this is the carousel, which is the bigger piece. So I'm going to select my carousel and just use the arrows on my keyboard. The left arrow, I'm moving all my content left. One click on your arrow is moving elements by one pixel. I want to move faster. So I'm going to click Shift and left arrow. And this is moving things by 8 pixels. This is what we call the nudge amount. In Figma, it's called the nudge amount. I show you in more advanced tutorials how to change that. But shift arrow is moving elements on my page. Now my user knows that they can scroll between different images. And of course, we can design this however we please, but let's test if it's working. And here you go, it starts like this. Now the user knows how to move between the carousel.